reconciled with him through the faith in the Father, and his son's relationship with the kingdom of God, and where he believes and makes up to another world. You are hearing the voice of a man who has never before spoken publicly. We won't tell you his name, but you probably think you already know his story. He's the man whose then 13-year-old son made accusations of sexual molestation back in 1993 against Michael Jackson. Jackson denied the charges, and in turn accused the boy and his father of trying to extort money from him. Sleep with it. There's a man who's not a relation. She said she appears to be a bit more strong and being very untrustable. And it appears to not just take somebody else's word for what's going on, but I'm like, wisdom. I agree with you. But remember, Ray Chandler wasn't there, and neither was the boy's father. His mother had custody. And Chandler says she apparently bought Jackson's explanation that his relationship with her son was innocent. The mother had declined to speak with Bayline. It wasn't long before the superstar wanted to be a house guest at the father's home tale. The father was a licensed dentist who had done some work as a screenwriter on the film Robin Hood Men in Tights. And soon VJ was caught in the spell of a man child revered by fans around the world. Was this a friendship? Or a seduction? Chandler says the flattery and his own ambition did completely overwhelm his brother's better judgment. And he did ask the 35-year-old celebrity sleeping in his 13-year-old son's bedroom a question that might already seem obvious to many parents. He asked him if there was a physical consolation. The mother knows it. The mother says no, there are good children. I want to live to be around children. I think your kids are great, kid. He brought it. He believes that Michael is telling him the truth. But as the buck tells, one night the father would learn what a mistake he had made. As the boys and their famous guests slept, Chandler says the boy's father opened the bedroom door to check on everyone. He saw his son, not on his own butt, but in Jackson's bed. The star's hand was resting on the boy's crotch on the outside of the covers. That was the key to saying, "Mother, my brother, take the mother." Later in the book, you say, "If you like the mother," he said, "wherefore?" After he realized that he had been killed, Chandler says his brother finally understood what had been happening. He suddenly realized that the friendship, the star's attention, his international travel, and the money that flowed from all of it might have another purpose. Nobody was going to believe me. One of the things that comes out in the book is that when he knows that somebody had accepted that without him initially yes, because that's what his son is happening. Okay, but the estrangement from family, not a corner, such a children, sleeping in on a consistent basis. Chandler says the father finally came to believe that Michael Jackson had seduced an entire family, the parents, into ignoring their responsibilities, and their son into a sexual relationship. A nephew of this thing, the star, who can walk around with the sexual stuff. And he called him, and he said, says he's no longer close to his brother because of a family disagreement unrelated to Michael Jackson. But Chandler says other family members tell him that today the boy's father is alone, and if he was close to only one person, his son. Those tapes from years ago still seem to reflect the parents in his and the star of a superstar delighted him to the welfare of his brother. Has always denied anyone good.
One of the reasons was because there was people that were going to kill the children and me, mostly my children.
Who's telling you this?
Michael's people. I didn't want to go to Brazil as they wanted me and the kids. I handpicked me and the kids because he knew that we weren't going to fall for any of their money, that it was going to be justice more than anything. The kids telling me that up on the top of the hill, there's like a little, like a thing. And Michael had taken up the kids up there to look in my bedroom, like a telescope thing.
Right.
And I thought they were kidding. And Michael wanted to see what I was doing in there.
On Monday, August 2nd, I received notification from the Attorney General's office that the investigation had been completed. After interviewing 163 witnesses, and expending an excess of 2,500 investigative hours, the California Bureau of Investigation determined that Mr. Jackson was not injured at the hands of the Santa Barbara Sheriff's Department. The investigation also concluded there was no criminal conduct on the part of Sheriff's Department personnel.
Here we go, Darren. Mr. Jackson arrived in plenty of time for his first court date just a few minutes ago. He was met by his lawyer, a couple of his lawyers, Tom Mesereau Jr. And Susan Yu. She works for him in his law firm. Mr. Jackson jumped out of a black Suburban and the crowd went insane, as you can kind of hear right there. A umbrella was popped open for him, and they all walked to the courtroom. He didn't do much other than acknowledge the crowd and wave to the crowd and let them know that he knew that they were there, and then walked into the courtroom. He is wearing white today. He was not surrounded by other family members wearing white, as has been the practice, because there's not enough room in the courtroom. 150 jurors will go in each session today, tomorrow, and then on Wednesday, so they get through 750 jurors. And they're going to select from those the 12 men and women and 8 alternates that will eventually judge Mr. Jackson. So there just wasn't room for the family. I talked to a family spokesperson a short time ago, and she said that family flew in from all over the world for this date and didn't find out until the last couple of days that they would not be allowed in the courtroom, and they were none too pleased, I can tell you. Mr. Jackson will be in the courtroom, starts in about a half hour now. He will be in there probably till lunch. Maybe we'll have a morning break, maybe till about noontime here, and then he will come out again for lunch, and then go back in, and then finally leave this afternoon whenever the last juror has been talked to and the judge dismisses us for the day. Darren?
All right. Miguel. Court and the abortion. Live pictures right now, Santa Maria, California. Fans, media gathering outside the courthouse here as the Jackson trial is set to begin. We saw a quick shot there of Michael Jackson leaving the courtroom. It doesn't look like he's going to come out the front door as planned. Maybe he is. You see a number of the deputies responding to his security detail. My guess is he probably went out a side door there. But you can imagine there's about 100 fans, we are told, that are outside of that courtroom, about 10 times as many members of the media, as you can imagine, crowding around that Santa Barbara County courthouse, waiting for the start of the child molestation trial. Jury selection has been taking place. It was set to begin with the first pool earlier this morning. We saw some of the people leaving the courtroom. About 300 potential jurors were told. They appeared in two groups of 150, one in the morning and then one in the afternoon for another court session. Jackson was in the courtroom. As you saw, he was before the Superior Court Judge Rodney Melville, wanting to make room for potential jurors. The judge had ordered that the pop star leave behind his typical entourage of assistants and family members that accompanied him last time he came to court. You'll remember they all dressed in white in support of their brother, their friend. Now, on Sunday, Jackson issued a video statement on his website calling
so many out of 150, only 66 said they couldn't last 5 or 6 months. From what we hear from attorneys, it's usually much more than that. Now we see Michael Jackson is departing. I think we're going to go to a shot of Jackson departing at this point. Can't see if he's coming out through the front door or not.
We are taking a live shot,
he came
Sean.
Here about
yes. We're taking a live shot right now.
He came here about, now you can hear the crowd. He's walking out now with his entourage, his security, always holding the umbrella over his head. It's interesting, you see he has an armband on. Now, in the past, the prosecution has complained about that armband. They have contended that he has had biblical references or the number 777 on that, and it's something that they have tried to get the judge to stop, but unclear if there's any kind of writing, any kind of message on that armband at this time. But that certainly has been a sticking point, some concern for the prosecution. But Jackson calmly walking out today, getting in the SUV, not really waving to his crowd. At this point, we can tell you there are people from France, there are people from Sweden here. It's just amazing the amount of people that the pop icon can still command at any given moment to come out and voice their support for him. Now, this is going to be about an hour and a half break. We're told that about 2 o'clock local time, 5 o'clock on the East Coast, court will once again resume. We're going to try and go through another 150 prospective jurors this afternoon. And those who say they can last the 4 to 6 months that the trial will take will have to fill out that 7-page questionnaire. We have not seen it, but certainly this is the kind of thing that both the defense, prosecution, will either try to weed out those who will support Michael Jackson no matter what, or those who are convinced of his guilt, try to get as unbiased a jury pool as possible, 12 members, 8 alternates, and we'll see how that plays out this afternoon. It should be interesting to see if as many people as this morning believe they could last the entire time and sit on this jury pool.
All right, Sean Caleb, they're live from Santa Maria, California, as you see live pictures of Michael Jackson taking off there in his SUV with his entourage, about an hour and a half break as the jury selection continues in the child molestation trial with Michael Jackson. We're going to take a quick break. More live from right after this. Thanks very much. Thank you very much, Lisa. And we are going to take you straight out to Santa Maria, California, where Michael Jackson has just arrived, a black SUV pulling up to the courthouse. There you see it. He is, of course, showing up at court for the first day of jury selection in his trial to face child molestation charges against him. There you see his legal, Tom Mesro there, his lawyer waiting for him. And the judge has summoned some 300 jurors to the courthouse today to begin that jury selection process. A total of 750 jurors will be screened this week. They'll be screened for hardship, and ultimately the judge hopes to choose a panel of 12 jurors and 8 alternates in this case. And we expect that process could take up to a month before a panel has been seated. There you see Jackson entering the courthouse, going through the normal security procedures that everybody must go through, wearing, as you can see there, his traditional white that he wore that last time he made the appearance with his entire family. Now, as we said, this process could take up to a month, jury selection. We've been told that the trial itself could last up to 5 months. About 1,000 reporters have been credentialed to cover this trial. And as you saw there outside the courthouse, the Michael Jackson supporters.
Day 2 of jury selection in the state of California versus Michael Jackson is getting underway this hour. CNN's Miguel Marquez is there. Miguel?
Yeah, the spectacle is somewhat smaller today, a somewhat diminished spectacle, I suppose. Fewer fans here, about 50 right now outside. But Mr. Jackson just arrived a few moments ago for his second day. And the big surprise, I suppose, if it is such a thing, is that he was not wearing white. He was wearing black. He jumped out of the Suburban as usual. The umbrella goes up, and Mr. Jackson was met by his lawyer, and I believe his jury consultant, who was helping them select the 12 people and 8 alternates who will eventually judge him, said a brief hello and good morning to them, and then went into the Santa Maria court complex here. The crowd to greet him this morning was somewhat smaller all day. If we can come out to a live shot here, you can see that the crowd is already dissipating as well. Probably around 30, 40 people out here, and many of them are streaming out of here. Mr. Jackson will be in court today to watch jurors cycle through there. 300 jurors will cycle through today, just like yesterday. They will be excused for hardship reasons, that is, if they can't serve 6 months on a jury. Yesterday, more than half said they could serve on the jury. At the end of this process, all of them will fill out questionnaires, and based on those questionnaires, both the defense and the prosecution will select which jurors they think could serve on the jury. Then next week, they'll start questioning whichever jurors are left. And that process is expected to take 2 to 4 weeks. And then the opening arguments begin. And we'll see how long this trial goes, 4, maybe 5, possibly 6 months. Kira?
Miguel,
or to wherever he is going, and won't be back until Monday morning when court is back in session. At that point, we'll go to the schedule that is going to be the court schedule for the remainder of this trial, which is 8:30 a.m. Pacific till 2:30 p.m. There will be no lunch break, and it'll be three short breaks throughout the day. A grueling schedule, but one that the judge feels that he needs to keep to in order to keep both sides moving toward toward verdict day. Kira?
All right, Miguel Marquez, live from Santa Maria there. Thank you so much, Miles.
Straight ahead.
Thank you so much.
In the last few weeks, a large amount of ugly, malicious information has been released into the media about me. Apparently, this information was leaked through transcripts in a grand jury proceeding, where neither my lawyers nor I ever appeared. The information is disgusting and false. Years ago, I allowed a family to visit and spend some time at Neverland. Neverland is my home. I allowed this family into my home because they told me their son was ill with cancer and needed my help. Through the years, I have helped thousands of children who are ill or in distress. These events have caused a nightmare for my family, my children, and me. I never intend to place myself in so vulnerable a position ever again. I love my community, and I have great faith in our justice system. Please keep an open mind and let me have my day in court. I deserve a fair trial like every other American citizen. I will be acquitted and vindicated when the truth is told. Thank you.
All right, let's go back to Santa Maria, California, and there is Michael Jackson once again arriving at the courthouse. And there you see right nearby him, Thomas Mesereau. His defense attorney is the reason that jury selection had to be postponed for a little while in the trial. Mesereau, as you might have heard, recently lost his sister, so the trial was delayed. But now Michael Jackson, with some people chanting in the background there, Michael, Michael, heading into the courthouse, now just about to go into security. As you might have heard Adam Housley report, there is not as much of a fan presence, if you will, outside the courthouse as there was at the very, very beginning of this trial. Jackson entering the courthouse, and as we say, jury selection will continue today. What they have to do is, from this pool of 250 potential jurors, they obviously have to narrow it down to a group of 12 men and women with 8 alternates. Michael Jackson now through security with his defense attorney, Thomas Mesereau, behind him. And we'll have more to come on the trial. What do you mean out there?
On all the sycophants who have led to his deterioration because they refuse to criticize him are what is the problem with Michael Jackson.
So he's surrounding himself with yes men who are just agreeing with everything he says, which is what?
Which is that you have to make no changes in your life. You're absolutely fine. Mm. Like these fans who scream his name, are they doing him a favor? The fact is that Michael Jackson does not need vindication in a courtroom right now. He needs a radical spiritual transformation. President Bush, who I consider a great man, admits that, you know.
This is a Dayside Fox News alert. Hi, everyone. I'm Linda Vester. Michael Jackson has just been rushed to the hospital. Details are coming in, so we're going to take you to Anita Vogel at his molestation trial in Santa Maria, California. Anita?
Well, Linda, that's right. There is another delay in the Michael Jackson trial. This morning, as the pop star was on his way to the courthouse, he was diverted to the hospital. He ended up having to be rushed to the hospital. We didn't know why at the time, but now we're hearing from the hospital that apparently Michael Jackson has a very serious case of the flu. And so back here at the courthouse, the judge told all the potential jurors that were in the courtroom, seated for the day's proceedings, to go home for the rest of the week and report back for duty here on Tuesday. Now, joining me now is Fox News legal analyst Bob Massey to give us a little information about this. Bob, you know, this is another delay. How does this affect the jury selection that was going on?
Well, last week we had, of course, the jury wasn't here. And then this week we have a short week, which was not scheduled. Next week is President's Day Monday. The judge is taking off Thursday and Friday. So next week we only have 2 days of jury selection. What starts happening to these jurors is it starts setting in that, you know what, we may be in for the run on this thing. These are the kinds of things that happen in trials, Anita, that people don't understand many times because everybody is living pretty much of a structured life. Many times, although this judge is doing his best to keep it structured, this is an unforeseeable thing that's happening, and he has to deal with it in a very careful way.
Now, we were talking before, you've seen many trials mm-hmm. before, you've witnessed many defendants going through this process. It's very tough for anyone to sit through this, but someone like Michael Jackson, he's a very fragile person to begin with.
I think Michael Jackson, and observing him yesterday, it was so out of what he's used to, of course. And it's a humbling experience. It's a difficult experience. Whether this flu is related to the stress from what he's going through, who's to say? But what we do know is this will be an arena that he's not used to. This will be an arena where he's going to have to live by the rules of the court. He's going to have to understand what structure is. He's going to have to understand what delays are. And most of important, he's realizing the people he's seeing in that courtroom now are the people who are going to destine his future. And so his participation and his the way he handles it will become very important. If you remember in the Peterson case, after if you hear the jurors, what did they say? They watched Scott Peterson. How he acts in this courtroom is going to be very important.
And just a quick word about the judge in this case.
Yes.
He's not going to put up with any nonsense.
No.
If he doesn't think Michael Jackson is really sick, he's going to say something about it.
He will keep this very closely scrutinized. He will let the lawyers know, listen, we understand people get sick, but he's right now he's going to err on the side of the defendant. He doesn't want to have any error in this record whatsoever. He's going to do the best job he can to run it tight, protect the defendant's rights, because that's what this due process is all about here. But he will investigate it to the best of his ability, and he'll make it known when this is over, probably in chambers, hey, guys, we're out to run. Let's get this case moving.
Okay. Bob Massey, thank you very much. Once again, Linda, Michael Jackson apparently has a very serious case of the flu, postponing proceedings here at the courthouse for a week. The judge has told this group of potential jurors to report back to the courthouse next Tuesday. Back to you.
Anita, thank you very much.
From Brussels, thanks very much, Wendell.
This is a Fox News alert. You're looking at video shot just moments ago of Michael Jackson arriving at the courthouse in Santa Maria, California for jury selection in his child molestation trial. As you know, that trial put on hold last week and the week before, several delays recently. Last week due to the fact that Michael Jackson took ill with flu-like symptoms and was rushed to the hospital on Tuesday, ended up being out sick the rest of the week. The judge saying better to let him get better and postpone it until today. So today, that judge, Melville, hoping to get things back underway. Again, it's jury selection. 300, hundreds and hundreds of potential jurors being questioned in the case. Also discussing the witness list for the defense. That's 300 potential witnesses for the defense. But again, the jury selection getting underway. We're looking right now at Michael Jackson arriving at the courthouse for that questioning of the potential witnesses, asking them lots of questions, David, about their feelings toward Michael Jackson.
And we, as we cover many events taking place, of course, the president in Brussels. We also have that press conference in Dallas-Fort Worth about the missing woman and her child. Joining us now.
Could have opening statements in Michael Jackson's molestation case by Friday morning. So far, the prosecution has used 5 peremptory challenges, and the defense has used 6. Those are challenges where they can kick off prospective jurors without any reason. But remember, they only get 10 for each side. So really, we are down to the nitty-gritty, and it comes down to a legal chess match.
The most dangerous thing one side could do is use up all 10, leave their opponents with remaining challenges, and then they can pick and choose the jury they want.
So far, only 2 African-American. So far, we have seen only 2 African-American potential jurors, and the prosecution excused one of them today. The defense was not happy about that. As for Michael Jackson, he arrives and departed looking like he was in fairly good health after spending a week with the flu. And any jurors who thought that Michael might have been experiencing a phantom flu, well, they were eased by the judge today, who said that Michael Jackson really was sick and this whole thing was not a ploy. And the star-studded witness list has grown even further. Names like Elizabeth Taylor and Jay Leno now join. Names like Eddie Murphy and Smokey Robinson. And now, most legal experts believe those people will actually be called, and they will take the stand. Hmm. Shepard.
Trace Gallagher, live at the courthouse.
There's been a Fox News alert.
There's some genuine concern for your animal. Well, the judge in the Michael Jackson case has established a pool of about 250 prospective jurors. That pool could grow if they don't find the 12 that they need. So far, only one candidate has been eliminated, an elderly man who said his health could not stand a trial. It's expected to last at least 6 months. So how will the defendant stand up to it all. With us now is Jackson's former spiritual advisor, Rabbi Shmuley Boteach. Thank you very much for coming in, Rabbi. First of all, what's your relationship with Michael Jackson?
Well, my relationship with Michael was really untenable. If you care for someone, and our friendship was real and authentic, you can't watch him destroy his life without voicing your strong opposition. And
now, why do you say what you put it in the past tense, your relationship with him?
Well, the relationship had to be terminated years ago. I mean, what was I going to do, be a hanger-on? All the sycophants who have led to his deterioration because they refuse to criticize him are what is the problem with Michael Jackson.
So he's surrounding himself with yes-men who are just agreeing with everything he says, which is what?
Which is that you have to make no changes in your life. You're absolutely fine. Mm. Like these fans who scream his name, are they doing him a favor? The fact is that Michael Jackson does not need vindication in a courtroom right now. He needs a radical spiritual transformation. President Bush, who I consider a great man, admits that, you know, a problem with drinking. But he found religion, faith, and it brought about a major transformation in his life. Look at what Michael has become. Even if he
What happened when you said to Michael, Michael, you got to change certain things in your life? What did he say back to you?
I said to him that you will live on in squalid infamy, your reputation in tatters. You are becoming more mannequin than man.
That's what you said to him. What did he say to you?
He would sit and squirm in a chair, and he was just unable to hear it. And that's why I think we're going to see many of these illnesses over the next year. I think this trial will drag on a long time. It will be a circus-like environment, because these illnesses are how Michael responds to pressure that he can't deal with.
Now, you say these illnesses, meaning what? His treatment of children?
No. He was in the hospital last week.
Oh, you're talking about his physical illness. Okay.
Michael, you say he's
a hypochondriac, or?
Michael, instead of really looking for the psychological and spiritual help he needs to get his life back together, has always turned to doctors who medicate him to deal with reality, and to his lawyers who get him out of scrapes that he gets into. This is the last thing he needs. Vindication in a courtroom will not bring vindication in the eyes of the public. And Michael is a man who's dependent on the public.
All right. Having said all that, simple question. Do you think he's guilty of what he's been charged with?
I do not believe he's guilty of molestation. But I think that whether or not he is almost immaterial. Because he can't go to prison. And if he survives this, God willing, this trial, what life is he returning to? The only hope for him is this radical spiritual transformation. He actually has a lot to contribute, but I don't know if he's beyond redemption or not. That will be dependent on him. Only he can rescue himself.
Supposedly none of us are beyond redemption. Rabbi Shmuley Boteach, good to see you. Thanks for coming in.
Patty
Ann?
Well, the jury in the Michael Jackson child molestation trial could be seated within days if this pace keeps up. Attorneys are making major headways in the selection process. So who is getting picked and dismissed and all that? A look at the all-star witness list as well. Fox News legal analyst Jim Hammer is with us. He is live outside the courthouse in Santa Maria. Jim, hello to you again. Tell us about
Good
this
morning.
Pace. A lot of the headlines today in the news accounts have been saying, oh, this could happen within days. Is it that quick?
It's even faster, Jane. I would say it's a lightning round of jury selection. So far, the prosecution's used 5 of their 10 peremptories, Jane. The defense already 6. If I had to guess, by around noon today, I think we will know who the 12 jurors are.
Really?
Who are going to decide Michael Jackson's fate. It's that fast.
Wow. What are they? I know it's impossible for you to say who are these 12 people going to be and these alternates as well.
Sure.
But in terms of who they want on this jury, each side, have you been able to glean anything the last couple of days?
You can pick a little bit. I'll tell you, the most startling thing that stands out when you look at the 12, and again, there are some challenges left, Jane. Almost everyone in the 12 sitting in the box now has children. I've got to think that's good for the prosecution, and that the alleged victims in this case are small boys who allegedly Jackson gave alcohol to and molested. So it seems they could sympathize with the victims in the case. Again, the prosecution got a little bit of an advantage in that they passed once already, that literally after 5 challenges, Jane, they said they were satisfied with the panel. That forced the defense to make the next challenge. And in this game, the worst thing to happen is to use all 10 of your challenges up and have your opponent be in the catbird seat, actually.
What is the reason for it going so quickly? Is that intentional on the part of both the prosecution and defense?
No, it's been run by this judge who's running this trial with an iron fist. He's limited each side to just 10 minutes, Jane. When you do the math, it doesn't give much time for actual questioning. There was a little bit of a moment where Jackson actually spoke out yesterday, which has been unusual in this trial. The prosecutor moved to remove the lone African-American juror on that panel. The defense objected, and someone sitting next to Michael Jackson overheard him say, we've got a keeper or keeper, something like that. So as the panel stands now, there are no African-Americans in the panel of 12.
Hmm, interesting. And, you know, you had mentioned the judge, and he was pretty quick, I guess, yesterday to say that he had checked with Michael Jackson's doctor, that he indeed had been sick, and he said, we are not being manipulated. I suppose that's pretty important to him running that courtroom.
It's very important. If you recall back a year ago, too, Jackson showed up late for court one day, got a lecture from the judge. So this judge is really making all efforts to make sure that Jackson treated like anybody else. And I'm sure it's a very unusual position for Michael to be in, to sit there silently 6 hours a day. I think he usually runs his whole life, but not in this courtroom under Judge Melville.
Yeah. And anything new, Jim, just real quickly about this story that came out late yesterday about the accuser, this young boy that maybe in the past had accused his parents of some inappropriate acts and then kind of recanted his story?
Yeah, that's one of the hearts of the defense case that's basically attacked the boy and his mother. One of the allegations is that the boy was part of a scheme to allege that security guards had roughed him up and even sexually assaulted the mother. The defense is going to go hard after this boy, his brother, and his mother. I think it's going to be a very contentious part of the trial. And then there's, of course, the conspiracy alleged that Jackson and his cohorts held them actually prisoner at Neverland. So a lot of excitement, I think, in this trial.
All right, Fox News legal analyst Jim Hammer, as always, thank you.
This is a Fox News alert. They're being dubbed the Jackson 12. A jury has been selected to hear the Michael Jackson child molestation case, and that jury selected well ahead of schedule. Apparently, the age ranges in this jury go from 20 to 79. The racial and ethnic breakdown appeared to be 7 whites, 4 Hispanics, and 1 Asian. There is no African-American juror on this jury. Joining us now for some perspective on all this, we have Fox's Jamie Colby, who's here with some interesting insights about what we can expect as the days move ahead. Certainly, a lot of people surprised by the fact that this jury selected ahead of schedule, and now we're going to be treated to a whole list of witnesses in the next few weeks. Celebrity witnesses.
That's right. Definitely names you know him. And I think it's possible that Michael Jackson, very similar to Martha Stewart, checking into prison early while her appeal is pending, may be planning an appeal because there isn't an African American sitting on this jury. And he's certainly entitled to a jury of his peers. But it's possible that he said to his lawyers, let's get this thing on the road, let's get moving. And so maybe some of the challenges they might have taken, they may have thought through. As for the celebrity witness list, Kobe Bryant is one of the people that's on there. It's going to be very difficult to shield this jury from any publicity. This is going to be a very high profile case, and moving it along is one thing the defense might be thinking about, that if they do that, there may be less press and less out there to taint these jurors. And I think that Trace is very correct in the fact that the alternates could play a pivotal role, as they did in Scott Peterson. We'll see what the makeup is of the alternates. They're yet to be picked. But it is interesting and significant, I think, that there isn't anyone on the jury that is African-American, and something that they're going to keep in their back pocket, the defense, for a future appeal.
Let's bring in Fox legal analyst Bob Massey, who joins us.
Remember how juries are chosen, and I say the word chosen in quotes. We don't take a human being and say, I want you on the jury. We exclude people from the jury panel. So the 12 who are on the jury are quite literally the last 12 standing. And both sides used up their right to object. Are there people on the jury that Jackson's people would prefer not be there? I'm sure. Are there some people that the government prefer would not be there? I'm sure. But once they use up their right to challenge people, the 12 that are remaining in the box become the jury.
All right, but now just procedurally, they're going to pick 8 alternates.
I think they wanted to... And the Jackson 12, they are the chosen ones. Today, the alternates are being picked to complete the jury for Michael Jackson's trial. Who are these people? And how about Jackson's chances for a fair and balanced trial? We're going to take a look.
If you do your...